a story written by a boy who tells on pages of his words and hopes and dreams and misery. The days are cool and then the boat out there, and you will be the heroes from them all.
From that moment on, my class started to become more like a family. It really did. Franti and others like him remained a problem. There are always plenty of Frantis for some reason. But I wanted to tell you about the day I told the boys a story about a patriotic student.
Well, you're a patriot yourself.
It wasn't the lecture I planned to give on that day, but it was a day when Franti and his goons made trouble for Croce, and I found myself overcome by a precious memory.
See, can't you catch?
Got no money and my arm hangs kind of funny. I'm Crossy.
Stop. Why? You his brother? I thought you were just one of the losers who buy smelly vegetables from his mom. Ah!
Who did that?
Sir, I was the one who did it.
Huh? Huh?
It wasn't you.
No, I was the one who did it.
Croce, sit down. I'll tell you a story. All right?
Great!
Yeah!
This is not ancient history by any means. It's quite recent, in fact. A boy and his mother boarded a ship at Padua, Calabria, 800 kilometers from here.
Mm-hmm.
Mom, I'm going outside, okay?
Be careful up there, Croce. Mm-hmm.
Such devotion to your mother. Nice.
Are you hurt, boy?
Mm-mm.
Aren't you the little Italian boy from the upper berth in our cabin? Waiter! Please bring us a beverage. And some ice cream.
Mm-hmm.
My name is Diego Delgado, and I'm from the wonderful country of Spain. My speckled friend here is Greek, and this fellow is French.
Oh, well, my name is Croce, and I was born in Italy.
Huh? Where are you headed, my Italian friend?
Well, sir, my mother and I are moving to Torino.
So you are moving because you lost your father and house in the war? Dig in. You'd better eat up before it melts. Hmm. So, what are you waiting for? You'd better eat it all up before it starts melting. Ah. Here, waiter. His mother's in second class. Take her some ice cream.
Uh-huh.
Wait a moment.
Huh?
What do you have for the boy?
Thank you so much. Thank you. Mom! 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 Hey, wake up! Mom! Mama, Mama.
What's this?
It's ice cream.
Ice cream?
It's a gift to you from the three foreign gentlemen from the lower berth. Do you like it?
It's wonderful. But you should try some yourself.
It's great. And look what I have in my pocket, Mama. The people gave it to us.
That's a lot of money.
With this, you can eat well for the whole voyage. And perhaps I'll even have enough left over to buy a new pair of shoes.
That sounds lovely.
Those are the men who sent you the ice cream and collected the money for us.
I absolutely must go down and thank them later.
Dirty Italians, even their boats are disgusting.
Just like your country. I swear we'd even be better off on a Russian boat.
Greeks have standards, and I have yet to encounter anything in Italy that even remotely measures up to them.
The only thing Italians excel at are stealing and cheating, and illiteracy. The border guard couldn't read my passport. A dirty, backward country of thieves and cheats, am I right? What is this?
I'm Italian, and if you hate my country, I don't want your help.
I'm proud of you for standing up for Italy.
I'm very sorry, Croce. I promise that I won't ever make fun of you again.
Oh, wow!
That's one patriotic story.
And the best possible kind, true and simple. It inspired the boys.
Inspired them how?
And showing love and strength to face the world. Don't need that much, but they will carry on. You always pray and look above. Don't let the troubles get you down, and never say goodbye.